Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about some kind of quirky exceptions that we'll encounter in naming different types of R groups. So we're going to talk about iso groups and tert and sec groups. But to start, I want to just look at a couple simple molecules. And we're going to use benzene a lot in this because it's a nice basic functional group or basic molecule. So here we could have benzene. We could have a CH3 on here. This would be methyl benzene. No problem there. And you might write methyl benzene that way. You might write ME. ME is a common abbreviation for writing CH3, kind of the same length, but that's what people do. You could also have ethyl benzene. And sometimes people would write ET as an abbreviation for ethyl. And that's valid. So then we can go to propyl benzene. Well, once we get to propyl benzene, when we've written this on the left, this would be propyl benzene. We have some options because there's actually more than one way that we could put this propyl chain on the benzene ring. We could also draw it this way. This would be another way to put three carbons on the benzene ring. Now, these both can't be called propyl benzene. They're different. They're isomers of one another. So what people do is this is propyl, and people call this isopropyl. Now, how do you get to an iso? Anything is an iso if you take, and I'm going to redraw this propyl benzene, take the end carbon and just have it hop over one carbon closer to the main part of the molecule. And that's going to be important when we get into the next thing, which is going to be our butyl groups. So this would be butyl benzene. Now, there are a couple other ways that we can draw butyl groups off of a benzene ring, and one is the isobutyl. So what if we take this end carbon group and let's hop it over one carbon closer to the chain? This is now isobutyl benzene. And there are two more. There's something called sec-butyl, which looks like this. And this, I find this is just one you kind of have to memorize. But this is called sec-butyl. And to make it even weirder, sec is italicized, so I'll underline it. But that is sec-butyl benzene. And I'm going to run out of room, of course. So we'll go to the middle of the screen, and there's another. We could have a carbon come off the benzene ring and then three more carbons coming off of there. And this is called tert-butyl benzene. So this is a full slide. But these are the different ways that we can have butyl groups. So as we have more and more carbons, we have more and more ways to incorporate these groups. As it turns out, once you go to pentyl, there are a whole lot more ways, and people don't even talk about those. They actually follow a different system. But these are the common ones that we encounter that are hard to, they'd be hard to figure out if you hadn't seen them before. So one more quick thing to mention. Propyl, just like we can abbreviate methyl over on the right, methyl is ME, ethyl is ET. Propyl we can write as PR. Isopropyl is IPR. Butyl, we can abbreviate a butyl chain as BU. Isobutyl, you guessed it, IBU. Sec-butyl is SBU. And tert-butyl is TBU. So we have abbreviations for these commonly encountered R groups. Of all these on the screen, I'd say isopropyl is pretty common. You'll encounter that. Tert-butyl is also really common. So we'll need to be familiar with that. But these others we will see from time to time.